What is going on, YouTube? Joe here with Cullination Media, and welcome back to another episode of The Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask. This is episode number 22, I want to say. And did I get that correct? I did. I thought I just butchered the inverse Song of Time, as I tend to do when I'm trying to commentate and actually make sense with the sentences. It just doesn't gel most of the time. Anyway, like I said, we are up to episode number 22 here. Today, our goal is going to be to head to the Great Bay Skulltula House. It's going to be the last one of the game. There's only two, obviously. A couple of episodes ago, we completed the one that is located in the Southern Swamp. And the reward for that was just the Mask of Truth here, which allows us to talk to animals and the Gossip Stones. Really not that big of a deal, completely optional. Of course, the second one is completely optional as well, although the prize is much better and much more useful throughout the entirety of the game. Before we get started with that, as I am just going around getting some ammunition and stuff, you know, just some arrows and bombs, and we're going to definitely need arrows, I know that, so I want to stock up on that. But as we're doing that, just a friendly little reminder if you haven't done so already, and you would like to show some support to the channel and the series and all that good stuff like you guys always do. Just a friendly little reminder that it only takes a couple seconds to click that thumbs up button right below this video. It does help out when you guys do that. And as always, you guys have been very supportive of the series and the channel in general. You guys are always there to support in all the videos, and it's really cool that you guys do that. So I try to just make a couple seconds in each video to, you know, just say thanks for all the support, all the good stuff, all the positivity, you know. So let's not talk about that. Let's get into the video here. We're headed out to the Great Bay Coast because that's where the Skulltula House is. It's actually next to the Fisherman's House. And he had the seahorse, and we had to give him the pictograph and all that jazz. Probably should get out the Zora mask so we can swim kind of sort of fast, because that is always useful. Now, the Skulltula House that was in Southern Swamp, you could have defeated that a long time ago. You could have completed it several temples ago. This one right here is one that you have to have the hookshot in order to be able to complete. So if you have not gotten that from the Pirate's Fortress, you need to go do that whole side quest first before worrying about this one. The other thing is that you have to do this on the first day. If you don't do it on the first day, you're not going to get the reward that you want. And then you'll have to do it all over again. And that's just, trust me, that's not a fun time. That's not a fun time at all. I suggest doing it first thing after playing the Song of Time. And I also suggest slowing down time with the, you know, inverted Song of Time and all that jazz to make your life a little bit easier. So right off the bat here, we have two Skulltulas. There's going to be 30 just like in the previous one. And this one is a little bit more difficult, for sure. For show. Just kidding, I didn't say that. You do need the fire arrows as well, but if you have the hookshot, you definitely have the fire arrows. We got that way back in the second temple of the game. Pull that out, because there's going to be webs that we have to get rid of, such as that one, and that one, which will reveal another golden Skulltula. So we already have three before we even get out of the first room. That's pretty darn cool. We're a tenth of the way there. I don't know why I feel the need to always, I don't know, do the play-by-play like that, but I do. But I just do. I feel like there would be another Skulltula behind there, but I guess not. So we can hit the target with our hookshot, and that is going to allow us to go deeper into the house. This is the main reason why you need the hookshot. Of course, there is no means of getting the extra tokens that will be out of reach without the hookshot anyway. Unlike in the first Skulltula house where they had the, you know, magic bean areas and that kind of thing. So, first things first, I guess we can burn down that. We'll burn down this little web as well. Fire arrows everywhere. And there should be at least one in the ceiling over here somewhere. Oh, we get rupees for doing that. That's cool. That is cool beans. I feel like there has to be one back here somewhere. It has to be in, like, one of these pots. And I I can never square them up right. Okay, apparently he was in that one. Well, that worked out well. I mean, I'm still gonna hit the other ones just in case, because with my luck, I would miss the ones that have the Skulltulas in it, like I did in the first house when I that last one. Oh, there is another one in there. Okay, look at us. We're already up to five. That was very, very fast. This particular Skulltula house has a much darker, you know, creepier feel to it. You just climb up on here because I saw you climb out of there and being all sneaky and jazz. Aha! Alright, we already got six. I feel like there should be one in the rafters here, but there's a lot of them in this house that are in the rafters. But I guess that's not the case. There's not one up there either? Maybe there's one on this side? Ah, I knew! I could have sworn there was one up there. I don't know. Bingo! So from up here, I guess it's a very clear shot. So we got seven. That's crazy. That's crazy. We're moving along very quickly. I figured this one would take a little bit longer, but I don't know. There actually is a heart piece available in this. I don't know if you want to call it a mini dungeon. It's not really. Wow! Did I really just miss that? It's not really a mini dungeon. I don't know. Optional area. I guess. I don't know what the official name of this place would. You know, be if it would be or not official name, but official classification. It's not a dungeon. It's not a temple. I wouldn't call it a mini dungeon. I don't really know what I would call it, other than an optional area. Is there another Skulltula in one of these? That would be kind of interesting. No, there's not. Alrighty, I'm pretty sure. Oh, there's a black bow. Okay. I remember you guys from the first temple. I think there is one in this jar right here. I believe. No, it's just a thing of magic. Alright, we could use that as well, so, you know, I'm not gonna complain. I'm not gonna complain even a little bit. We'll get back to running into these things. I'm sure there's one. Oh, there we go. There are so many in this room alone. It's insane. It is absolutely insane. We're already up to 9 out of the 30 that are in this entire Skulltula house. No arrows. We actually kind of needed that. We used up 10. And here's another. I see you. I see you. You do need the hookshot for this. In these little holes here, you have to kind of just run right up to it, use the hookshot, and you should be able to shoot through it, and then use the hookshot to grab the token. That's number 10. I feel like there's going to be one in one of these pots yet again, so I'm going to break it from afar. Yep, there is one up there. And I will use a bomb to kill it. Because I won't be able to get up there otherwise. Okay, that did not work the way... Oh, it still killed it. So I just wasted a bomb for no reason. Way to be wasteful. Way to be wasteful. Alright, I still think there might be one in the rafters down here. Maybe. Maybe. Or on that thing. No? Maybe I'm just imagining that. I thought I heard another one, though. Oh, there you are. Okay. Alright. That might be the last one in this room. Because 12, you know, we're only in the second room. I know this is, like, the lobby area, but that's still kind of a lot. I guess you could use these torches, you know, if you have Dooku sticks. I don't think I had a Dooku stick, did I? Don't think I have one yet, no. So if you came prepared, unlike me, you would not have to waste all of your magic and arrows. But they do give you a lot of opportunities to regain it in the jars and such as well. Alrighty, so we're up to 12, and now we can start going through the different outlets and different doors, because there was at least one on the second level, and there's a couple down here. So we should be good to go. Yeah, alright. Oh wow, an actual large Skulltula. I'll kill you with a fire arrow because that's always fun. Black bow. Coming back from the first temple. Now there's quite a few in this room, and I have to remember that there's at least one that's in the top area of this room that I always just seem to miss. So I need to make sure I get that before we head out of this room. Alright, let's grab you, since you're kind of just out in the open, just chilling there. Bam! I feel like this is going faster than the previous one. I Could be wrong about that. Probably am wrong about that, but it just, I don't know, it feels like it's going a bit quicker. There's one back here, and there we go, 14. We're one away from being half done. That's just craziness to me. Absolute craziness. Let's move, can we move these boxes up? No, we can't. I can break this one, though, that's for sure. Okay, and there was one hiding in there. I had a lingering suspicion about you. And there's got to be one back here. No? Oh, ah, you're hiding behind the... I see. I see what you're doing there. All right, so we're up to 16 now. I'm sure there's one in the rafters here. Or is there a rafter area? Kind of. There kind of is. I feel like there should be one up there. I don't know, maybe we should go up a little higher to be able to see a little bit better, if you get my drift. I don't see one. Okay, well, they're not gonna be all in plain sight, because that would be a little bit crazy. Let's see, where else can we go in here? There has to be more. Oh yeah, there's one at the top, that's right. The one that I said earlier that I keep forgetting. Let's get that right now before I forget about that, because I almost did forget about that. So I think we can, yeah, if we stand up here, we can reach this target with our hookshot, take it up to the next level, and there should be one like in the pots maybe? No. Ah, there we go. Sneaky, sneaky Skulltula. Alright, that should be it for this room. We're up to 17. And we still have two other areas to explore. And I know there's quite a few in the library area, which I want to say is this door through here. We'll see. We shall see together, ladies and gents. No, this is not the library. But we can get a heart piece in here. And first things first, we're gonna take out the captain's hat because that will prevent the Stal children from attacking us. I don't know if they would attack us anyway. No, they don't, so I guess it doesn't matter if you have the captain's hat. Don't kill them though, because we do need to talk to them. Put your sword away. There we go. All right, yeah, if you're just like shooting arrows around and flinging your sword around, you can kill them, and you want to talk to them. You want to talk to them. They're going to offer you some hints on how to get the heart piece that you're going to want to hear. You're going to want to hear them out, is what I'm trying to say. There has to be one in these pots. There just has to be. No? Nope, 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 nope. No. Why do I never hit them square on? I never do. It's gonna be in the, did I do this side already? Maybe there isn't one in here. Oh, of course, it was the last one. I hit every single one in the room except, stop targeting, stop. I don't wanna kill you. I don't wanna kill you. All right, there we go. Playing it safe, that's how we do it. All right, now we have these little Skull Kid portraits. We're gonna wanna knock them off the wall as well. I got kinda lucky there. I think that's the only one in the room. I'm pretty sure. But we're gonna knock them all down anyway, just to be certain. As I should get rid of that. Did that really not hit it? Seriously? Seriously. Okay, maybe I didn't need to get rid of that at all, because I think... Yep, I gotcha. I gotcha. We're up to 20. That is ridiculous. Ridiculous. Let's knock these down just to make sure that there's no extra thingamajiggies behind there. Only 10 left in this entire house. This is just going by quickly. I don't know, maybe it's not. We already talked about this. All right, now that we have all that completed, there actually is one more that's up here. Oh, there's three more. Oh, geez, okay. Can I just roll into the table and get them? Yes, yes, yes. All right, now we need to be careful to not kill the Stal children, as I mentioned, because they're essential to getting a heart piece. And, you know, I think one more heart piece actually will get us a new piece of heart, if I'm not mistaken. because we got a heart piece in the last episode of the doggy racetrack. And I think that was the third. Alright, so we're up to 23. And now we have these, like, weird colored things that we haven't done anything with. And this, like, gated door that we apparently can't do anything with at this point. So let's put on the captain's hat and see what these people have to say. If you haven't gotten the captain's hat yet, you have to go to the Akana graveyard. And I recommend doing that before coming here, obviously, because, you know, you want to be able to get this heart piece. Otherwise, you're going to have to, you know, do some backtracking later on, which, of course, is what Zelda is all about. Ah, Captain Sir, it's been a long time since we've seen you. As you have ordered, sir, we are investigating the secrets of this place. According to the information I have obtained, it seems Yellow should be shot fifth. Have I fulfilled my duty, sir? Yes. All right, so now, as you ordered, sir, I will finish the last of my duties. And they just disappear. Okay, so Yellow needs to be shot fifth. Alright, let's talk to you. So it's going to be a shooting order as far as, you know, with arrows and such. With the colored things on the wall, if you haven't figured that out already. Captain Sir, it's been a long time since I've seen you. What do you have to say? Blue should be shot second. Yes, I mean, I guess you could say no to just keep him around if you forget the order. Oh, we get arrows, that's cool. Now, there's stout children in the library that will help you as well. That will just continue this little talk. Let's see, what do you have to say? Red should be shot fourth. So we have Yellow fifth, Blue second, Red fourth. So something blue, something red, yellow. All right, let's see. Let's see what you have to say. What do you have to say? Yellow should be shot third. Okay, so we have something blue, yellow, red, yellow. Yes, okay. Alright, I'm gonna, I think I need to put my headphones in so I can hear this. Because I want to be able to hear the correct sound. Because, you know, the Zelda sound, you know, if you did it right, it tells you, basically. We don't need the captain's hat. We don't know which one is first, though, so let's try green. No. Let's try red. No. Let's try blue. Yellow? Okay, yellow is definitely first. What do we have second? Blue. Yellow, red, yellow, and then we didn't get what was six because we haven't been to the library. Let's try green. No, green is not it. All right, yellow, blue, yellow, red, yellow, blue. All right, so I was guessing on that last one. If you go to the library before this, there's other style children there that will let you know what the remaining one is, but instead of doing that, I figured we could just figure it out. There's a big chest up here, and we can kill the Skulltula that is guarding it. Oh, arrows. We definitely need that, because we wasted a whole bunch. And there should be nothing else in this room except for this big chest, which is going to net us, of course, the heart piece that I was talking about. So there we go. Pretty easy. You've assembled a new heart container. Your maximum life energy has been increased. All right, I think if we get one more heart container, we will start a new row, which is pretty cool. Oh, look, you guys are back. Apparently, I did not know that that would be the case. So never mind about killing them, because apparently you can just walk out of the room and walk back in. So yeah, just disregard everything I said before. All right, the last room is going to be the library, and I thought it was in both of these doors down here, but it's not. Apparently, it is this door up here. This is where we came from. And there we go. Hello, library. There's bookcases and everything, or bookshelves, whatever you want to call them. And style children that you can talk to. Let's see. Any secrets? Ah, yes, a secret Skulltula. So there should be 7 Skulltulas in this room. If there are not 7 Skulltulas in this room, we missed something. So we need to keep that in mind as we are searching around here. Are there any in the pots? No. We'll move this out of the way. Wait. There's something in the wall. Okay, there it is. I was like, I know there's something in the wall there. I could see the cracks. I had a sense that there was something there. All right, we're up to 25 now, so we have 5 remaining. And I should get our bunny hood on, because I think we can make that jump up to the next level there. Bam. Yes, rolling off the edge always nets you a farther and higher jump, so that could come in handy. Probably should take off the bunny hood at this point. I don't know, because I feel like I might just over jump, and I don't like that. We don't like over jumping. Okay, there's another hole there, so it looks like we'll have to get to this little bookcase in order to be able to get that token. Let's see what's on that one. Nothing. There's not going to be multiple ones behind paintings, right? Ah, the rafters. The rafter sculptures. There's one. That's 26. There should be one more in this room, I would think. No? Does he just go all the way around? Huh, okay. Alright, so that would be 27. That would be 28. Hopefully there's 2 other ones in this room, like I mentioned. Maybe I do need the bunny hood. Yeah, I don't think we're going to make that without the bunny hood, so I don't know what I was doing. Oh, that was close. I almost just jumped off of that. Almost. Alright, let's see if I can do this touchy controller to make this work. There we go, that'll be 27. Kill you. So we don't even have to jump over there and waste our time. That's 28. 2 more to go, ladies and gents. Hopefully they're in this room. I'm really hoping they're in this room. I thought there was a second one in the rafters here, but I was incorrect. Alright, let's pull out the captain's hat again and just see what this guy has to say. I think he's going to mention what the final colored thing was. He's, like, standing, I don't know, in the table? Glitchy. Alright, according to the information I have obtained, it seems Blue should be shot 6th. No, you have not fulfilled your duties. Is that so, sir? I apologize, sir. I shall continue my investigation. Well, now you're done. Yes, I just did that because I am a cruel person. I am terribly cruel and disgusting. Okay, Am I really missing that many? Can we grab... There's something back there. There's a torch back there. Can we grab this? Yeah, we can. Push it out of the way. Secret entrance behind the bookcase. Why did I not think of that? And there's 2 in here. All right, so we're going to be set. We didn't miss one this time. This was supposedly the harder of the 2 houses. So we have all 30 of the golden sculptures, and now we can go back to the entrance. If you noticed, there was no guy, like, standing there who was, like, cursed or whatever, like in the first one. But that doesn't mean that something won't happen. So now that we have all the golden sculptures in the game, we're done with golden sculptures. And do we need this to get back up there? Or can we just use the bunny hood, maybe? Use the bunny hood. This is one steep little area. Eh. Go, Link, go. Go, Link, go. All right, now there's this guy. Well, who the heckles are you? I thought I heard some loud noises inside and I came in to check it out. This place, is this some sort of underground shelter? Did you find this place? I beg you, let me have this place. Not for free, of course. I hope this will do. And we are going to receive the giant wallet. This thing is huge. It can hold up to 500 rupees. That is more than double that what we could carry before this point at only 200. I'm just glad it was something you needed. Anyhow, I won't be needing it much longer anyway. And he's talking about the moon falling, obviously. I just find it interesting that he thinks that I own this place, or he thinks that he has to give us something just because we found this place first. I guess, I mean, it's not like we own it. And how did you hear stuff happening inside? It's like underground, basically, and there really weren't any sounds other than me killing spiders, and I don't think we were that noisy. But, oh well. Yeah, you just said the same thing. Whatever. Okay, so anyway, if you do this on the 2nd or 3rd day, and the same thing will happen. The guy will come in, but he won't give you the giant's wallet. He'll just mention something about how he wishes that he would have found this place a day earlier or something. and you would have to redo it on the first day if you want to get the giant's wallet. Now, we can fill up to 500 rupees, which will allow us to buy one of the other masks towards the later part of the game that we haven't gotten to yet. And it will also allow us to fulfill our goal a little bit faster as far as the 5,000 rupees in the bank and all that jazz. So yeah, it's kind of essential. You do need to get this this wallet if you want to complete the game with all the masks and get everything and, you know, all the heart pieces and such. So with that being said, that is all I wanted to do in this episode, so we're gonna call it an episode here. Next time there are a few more optional things that we can do, such as getting another empty bottle. It will be the fifth one, I believe. Yeah, we have four, so it'll be the fifth. And there's one more after that that we can get, but we won't be getting that until later on. Anyway, I'm just babbling here, so that's what's on the slate. Of course, after we're done with the side quest, we'll be heading into the Great Bay Temple, and it'll just be a fun time. So that is it for this time. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you're leaving a like, rating, and a comment, and all that good stuff that you guys are always so awesome about doing. And I will see you all next time. But until then, game on.